Are you crazy? How crazy are you? Are you crazy enough to write a message on a potato, put a stamp on it, and take it to the post office for immediate delivery? That's just one crazy idea that made people rich and certainly garnered loads of attention around the world. Or what about building a roller coaster in your own backyard? Or use a PlayStation to study black holes? These are actually wacky things that people thought of, ideas that proved very effective and maybe changed the world. Here are 15 of the craziest ideas that actually worked.
It's a potato. It's a potato with me on the potato.
Number 15. DEET effectiveness. Diethylmetatoluamide, also called DEET, is found in your bug spray. It's the most common active ingredient in insect repellents. This slightly yellow oil is the secret ingredient, except it's not really a secret. It's been a highly effective insect repellent since it was developed by the US Army in 1946. When applied, DEET offers some serious relief from the pesky bug bites, as it forms a vapor barrier at the skin's surface that deters mosquitoes from even thinking about sucking your blood. Yeah, they're sensitive little buggers. The carbon dioxide and lactic acid in our breath and our sweat are what get the pest's attention, but it's the blood that they really want. DEET's effectiveness is twofold. The truth is that mosquitoes taste with their legs, and this strong chemical does all the heavy lifting. The little tongue-like cells on the bottom of their feet, which lets the bug know that this does not taste good at all, and while it doesn't taste much different than other similar chemicals, it makes them feel a certain kind of way, and they get the message that it's time to leave. DEET will not prevent them from landing on you. It's the landing in those tiny tongue cells on the mosquito's feet that lets DEET do all the dirty work. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14, Norwegian town sun mirrors. Many people's least favorite part of winter is the shorter days and the lack of some serious sunshine. And a super smart forward thinker from the early 20th century felt the same way and understood that sun is important any time of the year. Rjukan was built between 1905 and 1916 after an entrepreneur bought the local waterfall, known as the Smoking Waterfall, and constructed a hydroelectric power plant there. Sam Eid, the founder of Norway's little town Rjukan, had the idea of this sun mirror in 1913. Rjukan is the home of a thriving small community which manages without the sun for almost 6 months of the year. The sole purpose of the sun mirrors would be to redirect sunlight into the town. However, the plan did not come to fruition for another 100 years, and with the technology of today at designers' fingertips, making the sun mirrors was suddenly realistic, making Sam's idea come to life and delivering the sun here. But in 2005, the idea was revisited by Martin Anderson, an artist and resident of the sun-starved town. And so a computer-driven heliostat was designed and built. It captures the sun rays and redirects it into the town square. Number 13. I want to draw a cat for you. It may be one of the weirdest business ideas ever, but Steve Gadlin's I Want to Draw You a Cat was such a hot find that television's Shark Tank featured it, and Mark Cuban sunk $25,000 into the venture. Back in 2011, it started as an online business where customers can purchase custom drawings of stick figure cats. Gadlin first came up with the idea as a joke, a social experiment that posed the question, could Gadlin construct a successful business using only a widget? Apparently, he can, and he was not alone in that thinking. He managed to land a $25,000 investment out of billionaire Mark Cuban on Shark Tank, but it eventually became so popular that the creative mind behind the bizarre business decided to shut it down in 2015. We had a lot of fun, but it was costly to run and such a time-sucking stressor, Gadlin said, and he stopped accepting orders for the company, saying that the project had run its course. But that was not the end. Gadlin resurrected the business in 2019, but he switched up the creative processes. He used an iPad Pro and used an Apple Pencil instead of using a Sharpie on paper and then scanning it. Number 12. PS3 Supercomputer. Gamers take their video game consoles very seriously, as you're about to learn, and when the PlayStation 3 was released in 2006, the system was negatively received. First off, the high price, $599 for a 60GB model, $499 for a 20GB model, rubbed some people the wrong way. But the PlayStation 3 was praised for its untapped potential. and Dr. Gaurav Khanna couldn't have agreed more. The PS3 may be finding a new calling in the realm of science and research. Thanks to genius and thrifty doctors, a cluster of interlinked PS3s is busy with gravitational waves. These consoles were repurposed to produce what happens when a supermassive black hole, about a million times the mass of our own sun, swallows up a star, a so-called gravity grid of PS3s to help measure these gravity waves, ripples in space-time that travels at the speed of light. The PlayStation wrangles massive amounts of power, much like expensive supercomputers, but they're significantly cheaper. It seems that the PS3 is ideal for doing precisely this kind of heavy computer lifting. His eight consoles are equal to about 200 of the supercomputing nodes he used to rely on. Number 11. Mr. Rogers' inspirational plea. It goes down as one of the most iconic moments in public television history, and maybe one of the most powerful speeches ever recorded. Mr. Rogers' speech to the United States Senate in 1969. The reason? President Richard Nixon had proposed slashing funding for programming such as Rogers in half as the war in Vietnam raged on. So the family children's TV host stepped before the U.S. Senate Subcommittee on Communication to make sure that this did not happen. The man behind the PBS show Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood had gone to Washington, D.C. to defend public television and save it from budget cuts. But he ultimately made an even larger point that is even more relevant today. Sitting in front of Senator John O'Pastor, Rogers expressed his goals for each episode: to help children deal with their emotions in healthy ways, to instill confidence in kids around the world. And the senator had never seen the iconic kids show. However, Rogers' speech worked, to which the senator famously said, "Looks like you just earned the $20 million. Rogers' speech became one of the more iconic moments in the history of public media. Number 10. Million Dollar Homepage. Alex, too, was obsessed with one thing, and that was making money. Enough to pay his way through college. So he came up with the insane idea of the Million Dollar Homepage, and it's exactly how it sounds. The 21-year-old budding entrepreneur from Wiltshire, England, created the Million Dollar Homepage in a desperate attempt to pay for school. The concept is as follows.
I think I wrote down how could I become a millionaire in 2 weeks. Like, I was being really silly.
The homepage would sell internet advertising space at $1 a pixel in 10 by 10 blocks, and these advertisements would link consumers directly to the company's websites or online stores. And within 4 months' time, Tu had achieved his first million. 2 weeks in, he lobbied his friends and family members to purchase ads and use the money to hire a PR agency to help create a buzz. Well, it worked. It was picked up by the BBC and The Guardian, and after 1 month, the Million Dollar Homepage raked in 250 grand and was receiving 65,000 hits per day, with 14,000 advertisers ranging from rock bands to erectile dysfunction solutions. The website became an internet phenomenon, and at the beginning of 2006, the final 1,000 pixels were put up for auction. The final tally was $1,037,100. Number 9. Reservoir Shade Balls. Although it looks a little weird on a large scale, its impact is even more significant for the environment. Ever heard of a shade ball? In large numbers, these miracle spheres float on top of water reservoirs, which then helps slow evaporation and prevents sunlight from reacting with chemicals in treated water. Like you see in the footage from Los Angeles, shade balls are made of plastic, a high-density polythene, and carbon black to protect the plastic from the sun. The carbon black also prevents bromate from forming, which is a known carcinogen to humans. So the epic ball release, 96 million to be exact, had a major positive impact on improving water quality and actually saves the water supply, which, as you know, is a big deal in California and around the globe. Reducing the evaporation in LA led to an estimated savings of about 290 million gallons of H2O in 1 year, enough to supply drinking water to 8,100 people, not to mention the benefits of cleaner water. And the city has been using the clever solution for over a decade, picking shade balls over more expensive covers for the city's biggest reservoir. At the time, Californians faced a drought, and this was the best way to resolve it. Number 8. World's tallest man saves dolphins. It's one thing to be the world's tallest man, but now he can add dolphin hero to his resume. At an aquarium in northeast China, handlers noticed that dolphins were depressed and not eating. Turns out the dolphins had accidentally consumed plastic, and every time vets tried to use conventional veterinary tools to remove the dangerous material, the dolphins' stomachs would contract, and that tightening only worked against them. That plastic was not going anywhere. So they caught this guy from Inner Mongolia, Bao Zixin. Why? The world's tallest man had what they needed, and that was really long arms. Mr. Bao was confirmed as the world's tallest living man by Guinness World Records at 7 feet 8.95 inches tall. The heads of the dolphins were held back in protective towels wrapped around the animal's teeth, so Mr. Bao could not be bitten. As he reached deep inside the dolphin, down into the dolphin's stomachs, using his nearly 42-inch long arms. Problem solved. Plastic removed. Guinness World Records say this massive Mongolian was of normal height until about 16. But then came a spurt that doctors were unable to explain, reaching his full height of 7.8 feet tall within 7 years. Number 7. High score money. Ever ask yourself, why didn't I think of that? You're gonna ask yourself this question again right now. This is another example of a get-rich-quick online that might leave you scratching your head. High score money is an online leaderboard that very simply just tracks who has paid the most to be on top. The founder, Mark Colebrook, takes the pay-to-win contest model to a whole new level, as players win by simply paying more. For, well, bragging rights, mostly. But the plan worked. He raised over $2,200 in a single day. The idea for high score money came to Colebrook after his experience in the world of startups and crowdfunding, and within 6 months, money started rolling in. The list of top players primarily consists of players advertising their own products and services. Their thinking is that just being on top will generate attention to whatever they're offering. He explains, "For us entrepreneurs, revenue is still a nice way to keep score and see how well our businesses are doing." High score money was a success despite its transparent money-grabbing appearance, and it generated a considerable amount of cash for its creator. Number 6. Guy drives backwards forever. Harpreet Devi reversed the complete gear mechanism of the car in order to get maximum speeds when driving backwards. This driver has installed 4 extra gears on his car, enabling him to drive everywhere in reverse. And he's been doing so since 2003. But it was out of desperation he even discovered this novelty. The vehicle got stuck in a backwards gear and he couldn't afford to repair it and had to drive constantly looking through the rearview mirror. And Devi eventually got really great at it, and local fame soon came after. And eventually, his story went viral online. He can comfortably drive in reverse at 50 miles per hour, but the officials in India noticed, and so he has a special government license that lets him drive backwards. And for safety, and of course, attention, Devi has also attached an ambulance siren to the top of his car in order to warn unsuspecting drivers and pedestrians regarding his peculiar driving skills. And to let people know, grab your phones. You're gonna want to post about Devi's taxi service. Harpreet believes that he's so used to driving in reverse that now he doesn't trust himself to drive in a forward direction anymore. Number 5. The hula hoop. Despite being completely ancient and used for fun and exercise for many millennia, the hula hoop didn't get trademarked until the 1960s. Nobody can claim they invented it, however, when its roots going back as far as ancient Greece, people have been enjoying hula hoops for a very, very long time. Around the year 1300, hooping came to Britain, and in the early 1800s, British sailors first witnessed hula dancing in the Hawaiian Islands, and that's how the name hula hoop came to be. Back in the day, the hoops were made from metal, bamboo, wood, grasses, and even vines, but now there's no end to the variation you can get to suit your personality. Glitter hula hoops, noise-making ones, and even collapsible versions. Richard Neer and Arthur Spud Mellon founded the Whammo Company, and they became the most successful manufacturer of hula hoops in modern times. They trademarked the name hula hoop and started manufacturing it from the new plastic Marlex in 1958. On May 13, 1959, Arthur applied for a patent for his version of the hula hoop. He received a U.S. patent on March 5, 1963 for a hoop toy, and 20 million Whammo hula hoops sold for $1.98 in the first 6 months. Number 4. The rideable suitcase. Another why didn't I think of that moment. A Chinese entrepreneur patented an electric suitcase scooter. It can travel at up to 37 miles on a single charge, as fast as 12 miles per hour. The man, who comes from Hunan province, spent 10 years developing his rideable suitcase. The former farmer got the idea when he forgot his luggage on his way to the airport for a flight to the United States. The suitcase scooter does come equipped with a GPS system and security features. The scooter is all electric and has zero emissions, making the scootcase environmentally very low impact. It's powered by a rechargeable lithium battery and can be steered with handlebars when seated, and two people can ride the adorable machine. And it's been officially named the City Cab. There's apparently just as much space to keep your clothes as with a normal luggage, and when it's empty, it weighs just 15 pounds. And it's now been patented as a multifunctional travel device. Besides being the coolest thing at the airport, now you'll have a shorter commute and always make your connections. Can't you just see it now? An army of rideable suitcases racing to be the first on a plane? Number 3. The Pet Rock. At the height of its popularity, if you can fathom that the Pet Rock was actually a popular thing, it was marketed as the perfect pet. It doesn't make a mess, you can't be allergic to it, you don't have to feed a pet rock, so maybe it's true. And it was the brainchild of Gary Ross Dahl in the 1970s and quickly became a huge pop culture hit and is still talked about today. It certainly made Dahl a lot of money, who reportedly stumbled onto his pet rock idea while at a bar talking with friends. How drunk was he? Not drunk enough, because he got to work immediately. When you opened your own pet rock, the smooth stones rested inside a cardboard box featuring air holes for the illusion of your pet rock breathing and included an instruction pamphlet for care and training. All of it a camp joke. The gag was not so much the rock itself, but the way it was presented. In addition to the manual, Dahl conceived a cardboard box with air hose that resembled the kind used by pet shops today, and people loved it. Neiman Marcus wanted 1,000 rocks, Bloomingdale's followed. His bar joke was turning into a major sensation. Dahl sold pet rock t-shirts and pet rock shampoo and can still be found online if you're interested. Number 2. Potato parcel. What would you do if you found this on your mail? A little something different from your typical mail, right? It's a potato, but not just any potato. It's Potato Parcel, an American company and website whose sole purpose is delivering potatoes with personalized messages, or one picture. And again, another example of an unusual business that made it on the ABC's Shark Tank. The idea for Potato Parcel came about when then-owner Alex Craig saw a post about someone mailing a potato with stamps on it. He decided to take the concept a little further, adding customizable and anonymous messages to the mix. Customers can order a potato with a message written for any occasion, from anniversaries to birthdays. From $14.99, you can send a potato pal, a potato topped with a photo of someone's face. And the business appeared in a 2016 episode of ABC's Shark Tank and struck a deal. Since airing on the show, Potato Parcel has sold over 70,000 potatoes. The company now sends unique, personalized messages, which have been written on potatoes, all around the globe. Potato Parcel now employs 7 people full-time to create and sell the potato designs. Number 1. Bored Kid Builds a Roller Coaster. I know what you did last summer, and it definitely wasn't this. Logan Moore, 16, was inspired after spotting some scrap wood and piping in his backyard, so the teenager built a roller coaster in his own back garden. The Kentucky schoolboy spent 2 months working on the one-man wooden roller coaster over the summer break, saying, "I took a class in carpentry in school, and I immediately fell in love with it." He built the ride completely by himself, putting in 15-hour days over his holidays to finish it. The roller coaster is pulled up to the tallest point of this ride, an 8.5-foot hill, by a motorized winch connected to a car battery. Its top speed is 13 miles per hour, but that's not the only coaster he's built from scratch, according to him. "This is the second coaster I've built. The first one was smaller and I didn't like it, so I tore it down and started again." Well, if at first you don't succeed, try again. Logan's mother, Kathy, added, "I have to say, tears filled my eyes when he finished the coaster. I was so proud and happy for him. His hard work and dedication to this has been amazing. It should come as no surprise that Logan wants to be an engineer when he grows up." Those were 15 of the craziest ideas that actually worked. Thanks for watching.